friends, it is a Super Friday. I'm so excited that it's Friday, the day that I'm shooting this, because it's a public holiday. Monday coming in the next week, so you kind of get to rest a little bit. But I'm super excited. So I know I haven't posted much this week because a lot has been going on, and I've just been trying to close off the year as far as work is concerned. However, one of the things that obviously, you know, I do come back with all the lessons that I've learned during my time that I've been away. One of the things that have been on my mind a lot this week particularly has been consistency. This is something I've struggled with for most of the year, actually, because I'm a creative. I literally like getting... I'm a great starter. I'm an amazing starter. I'm not too sure about my finishing skills, and I think I've let that slide for such a long time, feeling like, oh, I can start this and I don't have to finish it, or I can hand it over to somebody who can finish it, and then it doesn't get done. So that really had me thinking, also making me feel like I've been sleeping on myself again, because if I think about all the things that I could have actually done and completely finished, I probably would be somewhere right now. But you know what? The grace is still there, and there's always time to get better. But it started making me think of how I can actually start making myself proactive as far as consistency is concerned. Like, what triggers or measures do I have to put in my life to make myself consistent? And one of the things I actually tried, if you follow me on Instagram, I went on affirmations week, where I dedicated my whole week to speaking the most positive things and the things that I really just want to achieve in my life, to speak them so much to a point where I breathe and I live them. And with that said, I did that for 7 days. I don't know about you guys, but it was so difficult for me because I felt like I keep sticking to this one thing over and over again. I was just so bored, and half the time I was just like, I'm not too sure if this is, like, yes, it's something that I really want to do, and I'm like, it's me training my mind to be consistent, but at the same time, I'm like, sharp, I have to commit to something every single day. And I promise you guys, that really helped me a lot. I think from there, going on to other things, it really has just helped me in my spiritual life and in my mental life as well. So one thing I can say to somebody that is struggling with consistency, because guys, I can promise you, it is a struggle. Like, for me, and it wasn't a matter of, oh, I'm lazy, I just leave things around. I just generally just lose passion of things too quickly. Like, stuff for me has to be super interesting for me to invest my time in. So I really was just getting annoyed because of that, because I just also felt like, why? Like, maybe this is not for me. Like, that's the line I used to use all the time. Maybe this is not for me. Maybe let me look for something else, or let me get busy with something else. Kandi, I'm actually just not following up, and I'm not being consistent with what I need to do. Learning to that, the thing that I've learned to stay consistent, or my mental trigger basically to stay consistent, is to just commit to one consistent act on a daily basis. So it's like, when I did the 7-day challenge, I committed to looking for an affirmation and speaking it every single day. And also, what helps is having an accountability partner, somebody that you obviously know that you need to be accountable to. So when I did the 7-day challenge, I had a friend of mine that I was like, listen, I need you to keep checking my Insta, I need you to keep checking my stuff to make sure that I am consistent, and if I'm not, you need to talk to me and you need to let me know so I can actually get it done. That really helped me a lot, because sometimes the reason why we're not necessarily consistent is because we do not have any other people to be accountable to. Like, when you're accountable to self, you can easily get away with it. It's like when you work and you have a job, the fact that you need to be at work at 8 o'clock means that you are going to be at work at 8 o'clock, because you are accountable to someone else. Someone else is accountable to making sure that you are at work at a certain time. And same with life, having an accountability partner, it could be a friend, it could be your life partner, it could be a parent, it could be whatever it is, but make sure that there's somebody that helps you keep track of the things that you want to do. Because I honestly feel like there's a certain level of push that it actually gives you to accomplish or to do the things that you actually want to do, which really helped me in this time trying to get my consistency act on. And I'm just really hoping that 2019 is going to be a series of consistency to the highest peak and to the highest level. And I'm speaking the same thing for your guys' lives. So I hope you guys had a great week and you have a fantastic long weekend.